Welcome to another Holiness Meeting from the Trinidad and Tobago Division, including St. Vincent and Grenada. We are glad that you have joined us once more and pray God's blessing upon you.
Thank you. Privilege once again to be able to come into your homes and to be able to worship with you. Today, the first day in May and the first Sunday, our Captain Paul and Manus will speak to you on the topic, you are royalty. You are royalty. And as we begin our worship, we would invite you to call a friend so that they can join with us, so that they may know that the Salvation Army once again would love to come into your homes and to worship with you. Just reading a few verses from Psalm 139, 13 to 16, it says, "For thou hast possessed my reins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. My substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Then thine eyes did see my substance, yet being unperfect, and in thy book all my members were written, which are in accord in continuance with fashion, when as yet there was none of them." You are royalty. You are the child of the King. And we want you to know that, and that you are special in God's sight. As we begin, let us sing, "Blessed be the name of the Lord." The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into it, and they are saved.
Most high.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. His name is most high indeed. We come before him and we lift him up and we exalt him because he is worthy. He has been good. When we consider what he has done for us, when we consider what we've been through, we can say God has been good. Amen. Just going to spend a few moments in prayer. We're going to sing that chorus, "Change my heart, oh God, make it ever new." Change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God, change my heart, oh God, I cannot be like you. One more time, change my heart, change my heart, oh. One more time, change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God, may I be like you. You are the potter. You are the like you, oh God. Heavenly Father, we come before you once again, and we come acknowledging that you are God, and that you are high, and you are lifted up, and you are highly exalted, and you are God who sees all things. You are God who knows all things. You are God whose presence can be felt everywhere. And we thank you, oh God, for including us, for coming into our lives and being ever present, even in the time of trouble. We thank you, oh God, for calling us your children. And as we are your children, we think about the beautiful creation in us that you have made. And I pray, oh God, that we in our minds would understand that we are like you. We were made in your image, in a beautiful image, even before we were created, even before our bodies was knit together, oh Lord, you knew us and you called us your own. Amen. And I pray, God, that we will have that honest understanding and we will walk in that knowledge that we belong to God. Father, as the songs would be, we would sing songs and we would read scripture. And even as your messenger would come, oh God, your word would go forth in boldness. Your word would pierce the heart and the ears of the hearer. And they would understand, oh God, that we are royalty. Our Father, although he sits high, he looks low and he sees us in the position that we are. And he calls us. He calls us and he draws us to him. So we want to thank you, oh God, for remembering us. We want to, oh God, thank you for crowning us with victory, oh God. For those of us who are waiting on you for an answer to prayer, we pray, oh God, that victory would be ours and we would celebrate you in that victory. Again, God, we bless your service, bless those who will listen, bless your minister. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen.
Praise God. At this time, we are going to sing another song. Our first song is 537. He says, I have a home that is fairer than thee. And my dear Savior has showed me the way. Oft when I'm sad and temptations arise, I look to my home far away. My home is in heaven. There is no party there. And we'll be happy, glorious, bright, and fair. There'll be no sorrow. There'll be no tears in that bright home far away. With me, Jesus has died that we all may be free.
Hallelujah.
Come then to him who has laid up for you a crown in that home far away. Let's sing. Oh, we'll journey to heaven with me. Jesus has died. No, sorry.
will be talking about royalty. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to be in the presence of royalty, or even living a life of royalty? We have watched a lot of shows about prince and princesses, or we might have heard a lot of things about the royal family, Queen Elizabeth, Princess Margaret, Prince Charles, and we wonder what it would be like to be prince or princess for the day. As we look at them riding of course on the red carpet, and their awesomeness shines as they smile and wave and greet the crowd, we wonder how special it would have been just to be in their presence. Some of us may have probably experienced that already, but I'm here to tell us today that you are royalty. We don't have to wonder what it would be like to be in the presence of royalty, because we are people of royalty. Matthew Henry writes, "All true Christians are chosen generation. They all make one family, a sort and species of people distinct from the common world, of another spirit, principle, and practice, which they can never be if they were not chosen in Christ to be such and sanctified by the Spirit." Peter tells us that we are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession. What a privilege to be chosen by God, to be handpicked by the King of Kings. What a privilege to be called a child of the King. Through this message, we will see what it means to be of royalty. When Peter says that we are a royal priesthood, what does he mean? And how can we live as people of royalty? The Merriam-Webster Dictionary describes royalty as a person of royal lineage, or a person of royal rank, or even of an elite class. Believers in Christ are of royalty. We have been spiritually reborn into the family of the King of the universe. We are now part of the family of God. We are now called sons and daughters of King. We are now part of the lineage of royalty. Peter calls us a royal priesthood. John declares that through Christ sacrificed on the cross, we are kings and priests to his people and to his God and Father. When we come into the lineage of royalty, there's a difference about us. If we look at Prince Charles, the way he walk and the way he talk, there's a difference. There's a sense of peace and calmness. His whole attitude is graceful and inviting. I have a five-year-old little girl, and we look at a lot of Disney princess shows, and one of the princesses that comes to mind is Cinderella. A lot of us grow up knowing and hearing about Cinderella. She is of royalty, but was treated as a peasant. She wore ragged clothes and thin floors. She she was treated badly by the people around her. When she got married to the prince, everything changed. Clothing changed, her walk changed. Those who treated her badly now treated her as royalty. When you come into the relationship with God, when you enter into the lineage of royalty, we should be different. We should be transformed from rags to riches. We may look like everyone else, but as Christians, our speech and our action should cause others to ask, what is different about her or him? What a privilege to be members of God's royal family. Peter says that we are a royal priesthood. What does he mean when he says this? In the Old Testament, in Exodus, God anointed men to be priests of the nation of Israel. They were appointed with oil and ordained as priests. They were consecrated by the Lord and declared holy to serve him in righteousness. They would intercede for the people of Israel and sacrifice animals on behalf of their sins. When we come to the New Testament, we see that Jesus took the place of the Lamb. Jesus became our high priest. He came and lived a sinless life. He died on the cross for our sins. And the veil that separated us from going to God was ripped into two, making a way for us, the believers, the Gentiles, his chosen people, to come to him without going to a priest to intercede for us. We are now called his royal priesthood. Just as the priest in the Old Testament represented God, we as his royal people now represent him. Just like the priest in the Old Testament, we are now adopted into his royal family. We are now appointed to intercede for those around us. We are now anointed with the power of the Holy Spirit. We are consecrated, set apart, redeemed, and restored. We are royalty. Therefore, as children of God, as children of the King, we need to behave as children of royalty. If we were to represent Prince Charles in a function, we would want to put our best foot forward. We would want to behave as though we are prince and princesses because we are representing Prince Charles. We would want to be of grace. Our dress code, we would want to put on the best dress code. And when we speak, we look for words that will be pleasing to others. We would want to do everything to represent him well. Know that you are royalty, and God has chosen you to be a part of his royal family. Therefore, as his children, we need to represent him well in all that we do. We need to live a life of royalty. You may ask, how do we live this life? 1 Peter 2:1 tells us to rid ourselves of all malice and all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and slander of every kind. If we are to live as children of the king. If we are to live like royalty, we need to put off our old behavior and put on the splendor of king and queen, of prince and princesses. Like Cinderella, when she came into royalty, she left her old self behind and now walked into the life of royalty. We too, when we come into the sonship and daughtership of God, we are to leave the old life behind and walk into the life of royalty. Our speech must be seasoned with salt. Galatians 4:6 says, let the conversation be always full of grace. Season the salt, so that you may know how to answer everyone. We are to walk as children of light. Ephesians 8:5 encourages us to live as children of light, to walk as though we belong to Him who is holy, who is pure and true, to let His light be seen in us. Clothe yourself in the Spirit of God, which is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. In conclusion, my friends, I encourage you to know your value, to know the worth of who you are in Christ Jesus. No longer do we have to wish we were prince and princesses, but to know that we are royalty. Know that we are children of the King of Kings. Accept our royalty. Know who we are. Let our attitude and our behavior reflect the splendor of our Heavenly Father. God has chosen us to be a royal priesthood, a chosen generation, His special possession. He has chosen us to carry His name throughout the earth. Therefore, our lives should tell of our royal bloodline in Christ. Our lives should tell of His love, of His kindness, and of His patience. We have an obligation to represent our Heavenly Father, to represent Him well. He has chosen us to represent Him, and as believers, as children of the King, we should represent Him well. We should show the world that we, the believers, are of royalty in Christ Jesus. It's time that Christians, that believers, are living a life showing our royalty, living a life as though we are children of a king, because we are royalty. You are royalty. God has chosen us. He has handpicked us to be His people. His people and the kingdom that He has built for us. Let your light so shine that men may see your works and glorify God in heaven. As we close, we will pray. And Father, we come before you at this time. we just want to bless you and thank you, Lord God. And Father, as we have heard your word, we are your children, God. And we want to live a life pleasing to you, Lord. We want to live a life that represents you, that shows who you are. We want to live that life of loyalty that you have called us to. So God, we, as we have heard your word, some of us may be wondering, how can I live this life? How can I do it? But God, with your Holy Spirit leading in our lives, we know that you have the power to show us and to help us to live life worthy. We ask God that you will take us even on. Father, that you will help us to walk the walk that you have called us to. Help us to talk the talk that you have called us to. Help us to live a life of worthy.
Thank you. Hallelujah. So glad you could join us for another installment of our online service today. And I trust that indeed your hearts were indeed blessed and encouraged as you were reminded that you are royalty and you are special in the sight of God. All of us need to know that we are loved. All of us need to hear at some point in time that we are loved. And our closing song tells us, the chorus says, I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. I'm so glad that our Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. This is the dearest, that Jesus loves me. I know that this is a familiar song for many of you. You would have grown up singing this in Sunday school, even at primary school. I encourage you to join us in this closing song. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. This is the dearest that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. Jesus loves me and I know I love him. Love brought him down my poor soul to redeem. Yes, it was love made him die on the tree. Oh, I am certain that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. If one should ask, how could I tell? Glory to Jesus, I know very well. Thus Holy Spirit with mind of agree. Witness in Jesus love me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. Oh, if there's only one song I can sing, then in his beauty I see the great King. This shall my song be. Eternity be. Oh, what a wonder that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. The final verse is, in this assurance I find sweetest rest. Trusting in Jesus, I know I am blessed. Satan, dismayed, from my soul now doth flee. Then I just tell him that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. Our fifth and final verse. In this assurance I find sweetest rest. Trusting in Jesus, I know I am blessed. Satan dismayed from my soul now doth flee. When I just tell him that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. I am so glad.
Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me.
Amen. Amen. And I pray that as we close, that you would go throughout the rest of this day and throughout the rest of the week with this assurance that Jesus loves you and that you are special and you are royalty in the sight of God. Just want to remind you before we close that our face-to-face services are up and running, and you can join us in St. Vincent, Grenada, or even right here in Trinidad at our Tobago Corps, or you can join us at Port of Spain Central Corps, Tunapuna Corps, Sangre Grande, or the San Fernando Corps. Know that a warm welcome awaits you, and know that God loves you and that His presence is there to welcome you as well. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity that we could again declare your praises. We could again declare your word. And we pray, oh God, that as your word would have gone forth, that maybe some soul out there needed to be reminded that they are loved. Maybe some soul out there needed to be reminded that they are special in your sight. That maybe in the eyes of others, or maybe in the eyes of the world, they are not much. But let them know, God, that in your sight, they are precious. And we thank you, Lord, for demonstrating how precious we are in your sight by sending your only Son to die for our sins. And we thank you for that demonstration of your love towards us. Even while we were yet in our sin, Christ died for us, oh God. And we thank you for that manifestation of love that you have shown towards the whole world. We pray, oh God, that you would continue to bless the work and ministry of the Salvation Army here in the Trinidad and Tobago Division. And as we include Grenada and St. Vincent, we continue to place our officers as they continue to labor in their various parts of the vineyard, and help them to know, God, that your word declares that we should be strong, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the works of the Lord, knowing that our labor is not in vain in the Lord. So may they be encouraged and blessed, O God, and may your people be encouraged and blessed, O God, as we strive to love and serve you better every day. I accept our thanks and our praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen and amen. And now for our benediction. We want to leave this closing word, parting word with you. Let nothing disturb thee, nothing affright thee. All things are passing, God never changeth. Patience, endurance attaineth to all things. Who God possesseth, in nothing is wanting. Alone God suffices. God bless you. Go in peace and serve the Lord.